Hi, and welcome to this video about my drill press workbench. My name is Dennis, and I am from Hooked on Wood. In this video, I want to show you my drill press miter station workbench, and I have to say it is not finished. And the problem is that I will not be going to finish it. So I will show this video at this stage. The reason why I will not finish it is that I decided to make a new workshop, a bigger one, and I hope it will be ready in the summer of 2021. So it is not worth it to finish this one if I cannot use it anymore. If you have a small shop, you must carefully think about where you put your equipment in a space efficient way. And we often have to combine functions in one place to save space. And because the miter saw only uses the front end of your workbench, it is ideal to combine this free space for other equipment. I got a small drill press that I could easily put on the table and still use my miter saw in my former situation. But when I got my new drill press, it was much bigger, and when I placed it on my workbench, I could not use my miter saw anymore. And the other problem was that the working height became too high. So I decided to put it on a drawer block under my workbench top. And in this video, I will show you why and how I built it. I made this workbench with a standalone chassis. And I plan to make this drill press miter station from three separate parts. And this way I could adjust the left and the right workbench at the exact height, which is essential for the miter station. And if you look at my workbench, you see that this frame looks familiar. And that is because I'm very satisfied with this kind of build. I also made a video about this workbench. And if you are interested in this, you can find free plans for this workbench on my website. I put a link in the description of this video. Anyway, if you have seen this video, the chapter about the chassis will become familiar, but the rest will be different. I will do the rest of the video with a voiceover, but I hope you will find this video interesting and fun to watch. Oh, and please, if you do, subscribe and leave a comment. I always look forward to read your reactions. I made this workbench with a standalone chassis. I plan to make this drill press miter station from three separate parts. And this way I could adjust the left and the right workbench at the exact height, which is essential for a miter station. I used underlayment plywood for my workbenches, so that is a very cost-effective way to make a workbench, at least the chassis. And making a chassis with all these thin layers of wood crossing each other makes a very stable and lightweight construction. I start to cut all the pieces slightly wider than intended, because I cut them at the right size after gluing them together. Because we want to join them together, we make the middle piece shorter. When that is done, we can glue the pieces together. I use my clamps in different directions, and the reason why I do this is the wood will not shift when clamping it. When everything is glued together, I cut them at the right dimension. This way you get nice clean sides without burning marks. And everything is flat and square and exactly the same size. Perhaps you will notice that I do this with relatively little dust, and that is because I use a different zero clearance insert. Watch how much dust the same cut creates with a regular zero clearance insert. And if you want to know more about this insert, watch my video. I explain why this one is so effective and how you can make this zero clearance insert yourself. After this, we can put the frame together. I use my clamps to tighten the frame while gluing it. And to reach the whole length of the frame, I put two clamps together. This way, you do not need absurd long clamps. To add the crossbars, I use dominoes. But you could also do this with some pocket holes. In my video about my workbench build, you can see how that works. And when that is ready, you get a solid and sturdy frame for your workbench. Because my almost 100 kilogram drill press has to sit on the drawer block in the middle, I made the true crossbars in the middle a bit thicker than on the sides. And I also put some feet under this middle section so it has a direct contact with the ground. For the drawer block, I did not use sliders. Instead of that, I made some dados. I used my router table to do that. If you do not have a router table or a dado blade on your table saw, a good way to do this is with a single blade combined with a curve maker. In episode 1 of my China Tool series, you can see how a curve maker works. It costs perhaps a bit more time than with a dado, but with a curve maker you get consistent results. After finishing the dados, I was able to put the drawer box together. I used dominoes to make this assembling a bit easier. At the back, I added 3 crossbars for stability. To make the drawer box extra stable, I put another piece of 18mm plywood against it. I also placed a crossbar on the inside top to better hold the heavy load of 100 kg. I made the drawers very easy for this project. I glued them together and nailed them with my tacker. With 2 square clamp holders, I made a simple jig to align the pieces while jointing them. If you do not have a tacker, you can watch my video about my workbench where I used pocket holes for this. With my ruler, I draw some lines to give me guidance for my tacker. When the drawers were ready, I only had to add fronts. I used some paper to get the same space between the drawers and screw the fronts in place. To add the handles, I use a cabinet drill guide, and I'm still very impressed with this tool. And you can find more information on this tool in episode 10 of my China Tool series. Now I could finally put the frame and drawer block in place and put my new drill press on it. The top of the workbench consists of 3 parts. The left and the right part will be screwed against the chassis, and a sliding dovetail connection will hold the middle part in place. The reason I connect the middle part with a sliding dovetail connection is the possibility to take it out. When you use your drill press this way, you will make its reach shorter. And I think even with this limited capacity, it is still long enough, but if you need it, you can take away the middle part and have the original ability. When you have a router and an accurate fence, making such a sliding dovetail connection is not hard to do. We start with the socket. This one should be in the middle. And by making another pass on the other side of the board, your dovetail socket will always be exactly in the middle. Now we set the zero of the fence at the end of the bit. We measure the width of the edge of the wood and transfer this number to your fence. Make a test cut and make small adjustments where necessary. But basically, this is how you make your dovetail connection. When we have made the dovetails to the top, we can add the workbench top sides. I made the top of my workbench with what we called full colored MDF, and that is something similar like Valgomat. I like to use this as a tabletop. It's very easy to work with and it is much denser and heavier than regular MDF. I know this is not available everywhere, and on my website I have a page with frequently asked questions, and here you find a list of suppliers of this material. If you know someone in your country that sells this material, let me know. Then I can add this name to the list too. I put some dog holes on my tabletop, and one of the reasons for this is to align the fence for my mighty station. This way I know my fence is always aligned perfectly and on the same spot. Another reason is that I found it practical to have some dog holes on the top of a workbench. To add these dog holes, I use the path guide system. It is very straightforward to make a pattern of 20 meter holes perfectly aligned with this system. Because we use these dog holes to align the miter saw fence, the holes on both parts should be on the same spot. And for this, the exact start spot is essential. We start with a 3 mm hole pattern that will be enlarged to 20 mm with this guide block, and I speed up this clip 8 times, so it cost me around 3.5 minutes to make these 8 holes. So it is very straightforward to do so, especially when you consider how accurate this system works. On the front side of the tabletop, I added a groove for my micro jig clamps. To reduce the stress on the router bit, I made this dovetail groove in 2 passes. First with a straight bit and later with the dovetail bit. At last, I round the edges at the front and put the tabletop in its place. In the end, I'm very happy with my solution of a miter saw and drill press workbench. I like the fact that I have a heavy and stable drill press with a very small footprint, and it does not limit the work of my miter saw. Oh, and did I already mention, it looks awesome. During this project, not everything turned out the way I thought it would do. So, what did I learn? You see a lot of holes on the top side of this frame. These are pocket holes. I intended to screw the top side of the workbench with pocket holes to the chassis, but with gluing the frame together, I put these bars upside down. So I ended up putting the frame to the chassis with some L profiles. Second thing is, I put some feet under the drawer block to get direct contact with the ground, and I thought it would be stable, but there is some small movement between the drawer block and the upper side of the chassis, so I had to connect them. And if I would design it this way, it would have looked more elegant. And the last thing is that I wanted to add the fans under the workbench top when not in use. But I did not know exactly in the beginning how I would do that. So I ended up placing a small piece of wood that held down the fans when I slide it underneath it. And that works perfectly. That was a video about making my drill press workbench. I hope you like it and perhaps got some nice ideas. Thank you for watching. It's almost New Year, so make the best of your last moments of 2020. And I wish everyone all the best for 2021. Stay safe and we see each other next year.